abduction of J.C. Lee.
11-year-old J.C. Duke taken off the street in front of her house.
Sounds absolutely horrific.
Yeah, I understand that management is not happy with my progress, but I don't think that any operative under the ex-core branch has dealt with as many problems I've been facing. I told you, I will finish my mission. I just need more time.
Explain to me exactly your previous strategies, and I will be the judge of whether or not you shall be allowed to continue. It's a wonder you haven't scared off your mark already. He must be as completely clueless as you are.
Well, at first, I decided to let my mark come to me. I figured the best way to terminate my mark was for him to never know I was there. Plus, cleanup was only one lift away. It was flawless. However, in my wildest imagination, I did not expect any of my research to be faulty. I decided that waiting might not be the best idea, so I proceeded to hit my target in a more public area. The idea was to follow my mark until I can swiftly pull him into an alley and finish the task at hand. Unfortunately, someone decided not to follow the rule of pedestrian crossings. I tried yet again, this time in a quiet neighborhood. There was no chance I would fail this time.
I hope that you're making this up, because otherwise I would seriously consider dismantling our selection and training procedures if an incompetence, such as yourself, could pass our selection process. So did you make any other foolish attempts to make your hit?
Yes. My last attempt was to take off my mark before he saw me. He was so close, I knew that this time I would finally hit him. Instead, Murphy worked against me, and my hit was lost.
You are a disgrace to your profession, though I use the term loosely, as it is fast approaching to no longer be your profession any longer. But I'll give you one more chance. And you better make the hit this time, or you will be decommissioned. Here, take this. Touch any part of your marked skin to this strip, and it will render him unconscious long enough for you to finish your task. But be careful. Don't allow any part of the strip to touch your skin. Wear gloves. Please try to prove that we won't be ashamed by your incompetence. Make the hit, and do it fast.
It all began with one kidnapping.
Abduction of J.C. Lee.
11-year-old J.C. Duke.
Response to several attempted kidnappings in September at the nearby Farrell's.
Taken off the street in front of her house.
Involved in the kidnapping.
Today, the unimaginable sounds absolutely horrific.
After they found her body, the White House administration decided to enact a new surveillance system so that it would never happen again. After the Special Surveillance and Security Systems, S4, was instated, crime was rendered inert. With thousands of cameras in every city, school, workplace, bathroom, and cow pasture, there was not one area of the great U.S. that was not monitored 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Police response was immediate. Justice was short. And crime was, for all intents and purposes, eliminated. But it's not the government that's abusing it. One year ago, my sister was kidnapped in broad daylight on a crowded street. But no one witnessed it. It was never seen by any of the 13 cameras constantly probing that intersection. It was never seen by any imaging sensor, never recorded onto any hard drive, never viewed by any surveillance officer. According to the official missing persons report, it never happened. For 2 months, I visited the police station twice a day, trying to get the police to act, but they never listened. This nationwide security system operated without a flaw for nearly a year, so when the police kept dismissing my story of an abduction on a heavily trafficked, constantly monitored street, I wasn't surprised. It wasn't long after they laughed me out for the last time that I learned of the corruption. Of course there was crime. It was rampant. It was going on the whole time. That's because the cameras always looked away at just the right moment, or a video feed was looped just before the imager was about to see something. Not even the highest ranking officials had power to override S4. Not without tipping off a surveillance officer. There was only one organization that had true control of S4, that had at their command the largest surveillance system ever created by man. It was then that I decided my new life's goal, to infiltrate it and find my sister. It began with long computer hacking sessions at night, drawing as much attention to myself without getting caught. You didn't find the network found you. After 3 months, 5 bank heists, 2 intergovernmental server jobs, and 1 almost entry into the NSA mainframe, I got a knock at the door. I was in. That was 6 months ago, and now I'm nestled tightly inside the network. In that 6 months, I have been an accessory to 57 computer crimes, 32 of them on the federal level. If ever convicted of these, I would spend the next 385 years in jail without parole. I never imagined the power of the network. Its grasp never ended. I knew that in the act of saving my sister, I would most likely not survive. My plan was to simply get her to a safe haven outside the world of computers and technology. I probably wouldn't make it to the boat she would leave on. My betrayal would be instantly discovered. That is why I am telling you this. While the network is powerful, it has one weakness. Anonymity. Take that away and its control would vanish. S4 would be disbanded and the freedom would be restored. If you're watching this, they've already found me. And now, they're watching you too.
Mark. Mark, wake up. You need to understand. We're not who you think we are.